Welcome to TV station of Yijing Feng Shui Weixin TV. Today is Monday, October 2nd, 2017. This is Fiona serving you the news of new religion of the world, the Taiwan Weixin Shenjiao of this week. First, let's watch today's Weixin feature story.
Hello everyone, 阿弥陀佛. Starting from this week's Weixin Shenjiao feature story,We are going to serve you the stories about how Grandmaster 混元禅师 helped virtuous fellows clear up doubts and dispel suspicion. Over 30 years as of now, Grandmaster 混元禅师 has practiced Dharma through Yijing Feng Shui so diligently. He has helped quite a few business people or entrepreneurs resolve their difficulties on running enterprises.They came for help with requests and queries they faced at work, such as unstable employees and unsteady production equipment. Due to problems happened occasionally, sales performance dropped rapidly. No more permanent clients and no longer purchase orders. People had no ideas why they encountered so many unexpected issues suddenly,which were in perfect conditions just a few weeks ago. With years' experiences on helping business people, Grandmaster 混元禅师found that people would be aware of the Yijing Feng Shui issues only when they encountered sufferings. Many constructions of factories or houses were built at the wrong time or established in a wrong way.Or even worse, that people were affected from construction belonging to neighborhood by blocking sunlight or breaking balanced energy. These changes influenced our bodies and five senses. They affected to our mind and our heart with problems after. Sometimes, one new built road or river removed with different direction would point toward the construction of factories or houses directly.This would break its balanced energy. All this would bring disasters come after another. Dr. Xu, one of virtuous fellows of Weixin Shenjiao, worked in Xinzhou Science Park of Industrial Technology Research Institute. He invited Grandmaster 混元禅师to give a speech to his colleagues about Yijing Feng Shui.Grandmaster 混元禅师 suggested those consultants always note whether the arrangement of office equipment and factory facilities follow the Yijing Feng Shui principles. If yes, then balanced energy would bring prosperous business and vivid life to them. After the speech, Dr. Xu and consultants reviewed carefully on all cases they have been supported.And they found that those companies followed Yijing Feng Shui principles ran their business so well. On the contrary, those business did not follow Yijing Feng Shui principles were still struggling with problem. If Yijing Feng Shui principles were used badly, it would cause people feel anxious. You do not even think about running a successful business.If those companies went bankrupt, debt would accumulate rapidly and troubles would bring to the society. This caused inharmonious society. In other words, if Yijing Feng Shui principles were used well-rounded in life, people would live in balanced status at work, at home, and bring positive energy to the society to become stabilized and peaceful.Yijing Feng Shui influenced everyone's life every day and everywhere, also in our working days and the society. Afterwards, we will serve you more case sharing through the upcoming Weixin Shenjiao feature story. See you next week.
For this week, Grandmaster 混元禅师's footprint. Grandmaster 混元禅师 went to Tianmiao Temple in Miaoli County, Yuanli Township,for dotting and setting the seat to Tianmiao Temple's major god, Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva. Let's watch the footage of the completion ceremony in Tianmiao Temple on September 26th. Take a look.
Invited by Mr. Gan Shifeng, the human guardian of Tianmiao Temple in Miaoli County, Yuanli Township, Grandmaster Hu Yuanshanshi went to administer the seat completion ceremony of Tianmiao Temple on the 26th. Tianmiao Temple also invited Master Yuan Meng of Weixin Shenzhou Chanting College and Sutra Residing Masters to administer the Buddhist rites. Abbot and Virtuous Fellow of Yuanli Branch Temple went to send their congratulatory messages too. Sutra chanting of the ceremony started in early morning on September 26th. It aimed to invite Buddha and the heavenly sages to dignify and bless the mandala with their grace. Mr. Gan piously prayed for the mercy of the Buddha and the Bodhisattvas. He wished the light of Buddha sheds on the surroundings of the temple and protects the people in the neighborhood. Grandmaster Hu Yuanshanshi arrived at Chen Shi of the Chinese clock. After a short break, he administered the seat completion ceremony of the deities of Tianmiao Temple, which he politely requested the deities to ascend to their thrones. Grandmaster also consecrated the icons, evoked the lights of the deities to instill into the inanimate idols, which serve to guard the safety of the neighborhood in the future. The heavenly generals and soldiers of the five camps were also consecrated. Grandmaster Hu Yuanshanshi reminded Mr. Gan to send his wishes to the Lord of the Ninth Heaven, Renhui Wang, for dispatching the heavenly Dharma protectors for the support of the temple. Grandmaster Hu Yuanshanshi and the human guardian of Tianmiao Temple, Virtuous Fellow Gan, and Chairperson Luo together unveiled the mantle of the temple and delivered their speeches.
And Liu said,
After the completion of the ceremony, Grandmaster Hu Yuanshanshi went to Yuanli Branch Temple. He instructed Master Yuan You of the construction of the building and the maintenance of the surroundings. He also talked about the righteous perspectives and manners regarding religious practice. Life, death, aging, and sickness are inevitable. People should choose to practice on the right path. Weixin News, Yuanli.
Take a break. We will come back soon.
易经风水是华人祖先留。
维新圣教 held the disaster elimination and benediction ritual on the heavenly altar of Taiwan Nantou Changjishan Xianfo Temple. Started from July 7th and completed on August 8th of lunar calendar, the ritual had been preceded for 1 month. In order to eliminate disputes among human beings and nations, to dispel the upsurging outbreak of war, and to pray for world peace and human harmony, All Weixin Virtuous Fellows had chanted Weixin Shenjiao 30 scriptures to transfer the merit to 10 Dharma directions.
Weixin Shenjiao held a disaster elimination and a benediction ritual at the headquarters Xianfu Temple, complete on September 27th. The ritual has been proceeded for 1 month. All Weixin Virtuous Fellows made effort to chant the Guigu Immortal Master Heavenly Virtue Sutra for 567,745 times to transfer the merits to all spirits who invited to attend this ritual. We prayed for the Dharma protectors of the Heaven of Dragons, watch over the sentient beings, and resolve the caches and pacify worlds. We hope for respect and admiration for humanity and eternal world peace. Grandmaster Wen Yuan transmitted the following instruction in front of a heavenly order in the afternoon on September 27th.
丁酉年八月八日，我们在禅机山仙佛寺总本山，圆满天命所交付给我们的所有维新贤士，为国修道，为民祈福，为世界和平而努力，共修一切圣法。这个因缘从无量劫来累积到当下的天运啊，这个法宴我们是以王禅老祖所开示的经宝来感恩，来供养啊，尤其本坛这次从七月七日开始升坛，到八月八日共31天的法会在天坛啊，我们的天命，我们的责任，这是应该的，没有功德可言。天下一家亲，天下太平，是王禅老祖导驾慈航的本愿，也是台湾祖师导驾慈航的本愿。世事无常，人生无常，但是啊，这个无常都有因缘果报啊，这因从哪里开始，缘从哪里开始，报从哪里结束，都是一个因地果还生。王禅老祖慈悲开示，要我们所有维新贤士弟子们时时刻刻本着为国修道，为民祈福，为世界和平而努力。
Grandmaster Wen Yuan Chanshi instructed that all virtuous fellows are in the possession of compassion and widen with warm heart, turning the Dharma wheel, eliminating disasters and resolving grievances together. After the ritual was complete, sending ashes treasures of him to Weixin Shenjiao General Russia, spreading ashes treasures to the ground around the outer Trigrand Holy City, and serving to the Bodhisattva and the Buddhas by Master Yuan Yi and Weixin Virtuous Fellows on September 28. Weixin News, Nantou.
Continue on Yijing Feng Shui Education News. The oath-taking ceremony of the Fourth Weixin Shenjiao Yijing University Lecturer Training Program was held on September 23rd. Take a look.
The oath-taking ceremony of the Fourth Weixin Shenjiao Yijing University Lecture Training Program was held at the Thousand Buddha Zen Hall of Xianfo Temple on September 23rd. Director of Lecture Training Office Master Yuan Ping led all students to piously make their oaths before Wang Chan Lao Zu, the deities Buddha and Bodhisattva. They vowed from the bottom of their heart to cultivate themselves for the benefits of the country and humanity, make good karma to develop love and compassion for benediction of virtue and merit without any reserve and regrets. Weixin Shenjiao's founding purpose is to raise and cultivate talented people, revitalize and cultivate people's morals, refine ambitions, create universal harmony. We aim at self-cultivation to benefit of the country and humanity. Therefore, we established lecture training program to educate disciples in spreading the Dharma and holding lessons on Yijing Feng Shui. All students of the lecture training program should keep 12 commandments and 8 great vows to become sages with great achievement and turn the Dharma wheel of world peace together. Weixin Virtuous Fellows respectfully invited Grandmaster Hui Yuan Chan Shi to administer the oath. Grandmaster encouraged all students.
大家务必要注意自己的行为。我们是养贤。各位都是贤者贤士贤士啊啦啊那么贤士贤者已经有贤者的修养比如有的我们准讲师啊一旦给他准讲师了开始出去啊都会赶快看出吃不三杯硬菜就要爬上天你只是一个论文东抄西抄抄过来了啊你在外面那个出头就很不好啊那个坏习惯影响到神格影响到老祖的尊严影响到维新圣教的教格影响到你们自己的人格啊，更影响到你们的祖先祖德流芳这一生有机会进入维新圣教书信班是修多少事才有机会进来结果呢你们认为和一般的啊不重要糊里糊涂安得来了我感到很可惜啊也感觉很悲哀啊啊你们要用这样来考到你们考到自己去考不要去影响到社会影响到大家啊对你们的见看法啊误解这样都是有罪啊所以你们拼命的按超度那么自己就平时就要先超度在先啊你自己平时不超度以后你超度怎么超度呢所以借我们书信班比一般的同修进入中文来学修更进一步的机缘啊所以我们啊还有说直至成圣成贤成佛这是我们的目标啊
Grandmaster Hui Yuan Chan Shi encouraged the Weixin Virtuous Fellows to be a very humble, modest guy with massive talent. Besides, he encouraged all students to follow strictly to their oaths and practice them in daily lives. If they could take their oaths and act cautiously, very soon they will attain enlightenment. Weixin News, Weixin Shenjiao Headquarters, Xianfo Temple.
Take a break. We will come back soon. The 14th Weixin World Peace Summit Forum was held in the Thousand Buddha Zen Hall of Changji Shan Xianfo Temple on September 23rd. Let's watch the footage and listen to Grandmaster Hui Yuan Chan Shi's instruction together.
The 14th Weixin World Peace Summit Forum was held in the Thousand Buddha Zen Hall of Changji Shan Xianfo Temple on September 23rd. The forum invited four masters publishing their research in I Ching Feng Shui to the virtuous fellows. We have Master Yuan Hua, Master Yuan Xian, Master Yuan Cheng, and Master Yuan Hui. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chen Shi gave some instructions to the virtuous fellows.
所以论坛的目标目的就是要讲主任人他们所经历的经验提出来给大家来作为了解以华会友以华会心你这个华你听了之后有遇到同样问题的那你就如数我闻我们某某法师在哪里论坛所开示的这个真理是怎么样我相信呢你用这样的话可以帮助很多人也帮助你们所学的你们的信心和这个水准所以我们讲师准讲师还有我们的师训班的同修你们学到不要说 我是这样我讲这样就这样这呢就是江湖先生那我们就不要这样我们一定要有引经据典一定要有有人证物证还有实证那样的话正法才是真的
The forum started after Master Yuan Ping giving welcome opening as host. Starting from Master Yuan Hua, he elaborated the essence of divination. Everyone learned I Ching Feng Shui. Adults and children are all clever by sharing cases and I Ching Feng Shui promotion activities. Continuing by Master Yuan Xian, he proved how to avoid impending trouble and seek good luck by selecting an auspicious day of groundbreaking construction to avoid bad energy and evil. Through the actual cases assisted by Master Yuan Xian on resolving disasters of damages, sickness, and accidents caused from house renovation,roof maintenance, or even drilling holes without selecting an auspicious day. He also illustrated how to select an auspicious day and time to avoid evil and seek good luck. The Master Yuan Cheng shared his consciousness of learning I Ching Feng Shui by telling virtuous fellows that the true Dharma is unlimited and unpredicted, and the cause-effect relation would be always existing. Next, Master Yuan Hui shared his own experience entering the Dharma to the virtuous fellows and hoped people would be encouraged by his journey and develop wider influence to benefit more people. Weixin News Headquarters, Chanjishan Xianfo Temple.
Kaohsiung Branch Temple had been founded from August 1st, 2002. On behalf of Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chen Shi, the first abbot, Master Yuan He, preached the Chinese cultural orthodoxy I Ching Feng Shui and devoted to benefit people. This year is the 15th year for Kaohsiung Branch Temple, and the 15th disaster elimination and benediction ritual was held on September 23rd.The new abbot, Master Yuan Pu, led virtuous fellows and believers from 10 Dharma directions to chant sutras and make benedictions.
维新圣教高雄 Branch Temple held the 15th Disaster Elimination and Benediction Ritual on September 23rd and 24th. Master Yuan Pu invited Master Yuan Meng of 维新圣教 Chanting College to officiate at the ritual and led virtuous fellows and believers from 10 Dharma directions to chant sutras and benediction, and inviting Wang Chen Lao Tzu and everybody Sattvas to the mandala mercifully and bless everyone happiness.They held the lotus days of 50,650 surnames of Chinese ancestors, 917 Chinese emperors and their family spirits, the rest of 3,760 rulers in China and each surname of the ancestors in Kaohsiung Branch Temple. In the afternoon of September 23rd, they had spirit-faring light and summon cell. Besides, they also chanting Guan Yu Immortal Master Heavenly Virtual Sutra. 王传老子 Profound Sutra, 维新圣教 Ha Calmness Sutra, Universal Door of 观世音 Bodhisattva, the Amitabha Sutra, and so on. The dedication of Marie O gave to the souls on a lotus seat. On September 24th, they made an offering of 3 dew and helped the souls could be satisfied and went to the Western Pure Land of Ultimate Bliss.When the Raja Guru summoned the souls, Master Yuan Pu was so touching, and he hoped that 10 Dharma directions could come to listen to the wondrous Dharma. After the offering of 3 dew, the righteous fellows of Kaohsiung Bridge Temple all did their best on the decoration of the ritual, preparing the food and cleaning. The ritual was wonderful and everyone was happy. Waxing news at the Kaohsiung Bridge Temple.
New Religion of the World, Taiwan Weixin Shenjiao boasts modern and practical Yijing Feng Shui culture, as well as religious inclusiveness. Weixin News is dedicated to providing you with the most abundant and diverse news about the development of Weixin World. Thank you for tuning in today. Please join us on Monday evening at 11:30, Tuesday morning at 11:30 and 4:30 p.m.王禅老祖 bless you and your family. See you next week.